Hello and welcome to another FS19 mod review. So this time we're looking at this front rotor arm. Now I've looked at one of these before which came out as a mod as a lizard. This one is the actual real deal and branded. And it looks very good. It says for use with a Mashua Dominator, but as I haven't got one of those, I have got on the in-game Rabi Pal Harrow. I've also brought down with me a Ferropress to try on it. Just something different. A few of the UK based guys may know why, because Dadswell used to make something along those lines. So we've got dynamic hose capability on it. It's hooked up to the plugs on the tractor. Well, on one side anyway. There isn't a plug this side. Not quite sure what's gone on there. But it does look good. Nicely textured. Always good to have the real brand name in. So just get that unfolded. Have a look at that unfolding. So it lifts off the stand there. PTO shaft goes in. Ram goes down. And you see it, it's all hooked up as it should be. We have got hoses hanging down the front there. As there's no hose connections, it's understandable. It appears this tractor doesn't have a front PTO, which I didn't notice when I spec'd that. So, the question is it actually going to turn on as I haven't got a front PTO? Yes, I will put it on the track with the front PTO just to test. So look at what other functions we can do with this. And there's going to be a few, I'd imagine. So we've got, get this just back to the right implement. So we've got chain and N, they relate to the tractor, and left shift J and N relate to the tractor as well. So all this one actually does. It goes left to right. Doesn't move in and out. It does go over there nicely. Get back the other way. Turned on. Get the flow facing the right way. So it's picked up the width of that well. So we turn it down to what the flow is by itself. This time. Power harrow is on the ground. GPS setup so we can actually see what that's doing. I just have to lower the tractor's front suspension to get this to go right. Going. Just to shift the line over. Down. So it's working quite nicely there. Things to turn over at the end of the field of this. Matches up okay. Got the offset the wrong way around. Working rather well there. So what we'll do is we'll just try and put that thoroughbred on this. Just as an experiment really, see if it'll work or not. Back up for that, so just make sure we're on the right implement. Let's drop that off. Just curious really for this one. Just to see if that'll work or not. The minute we try and pick it up. I moved it down here on the front hitch support for this. It's always good to try something like this. Doesn't like something there. Don't think they like each other somehow. Always tell if there's a bit of a conflict going on. And there's certainly a bit of a conflict between those two. Unless you unfold the press arms, which is interesting. So in the case of this one, I think we better jack the front up again. Turn that plow over. I don't know if that's going to work. All we do is mod the furrow press and get rid of the press arms off it and the collisions off them. So I guess that was what was causing it. So that actually works quite nicely. Okay, so the top link doesn't connect up there. Nonetheless, it works. I have to say, I actually like this rotor arm better than the first one we looked at. So let's have a look at this in the shop now. So we get to this end. Finally got everything straightened up. So, in the shop here, it's under Power Harrows, 15,600. Pounds, needs a tractor of 300 horsepower, 12k forward speed, and handles things up to 3 metres wide. There we go. So that is where we'll leave this mod review. So for now, I'll say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.